topic, what we are going to do is we will be analyzing as to what are the various steps which will lead to the preparation of your accrual account accounts. What are the various statements which have to be generated, and what is the procedure we are adopting in Railways to shift from our present system of accounting to accrual system of accounting, and how are we preparing our statements? That's the basic objective of this session. It's going to be a very broad based session. It's not going to be anything specific with any single objective, because the entire session will be based on the type of questions which you are raising and different questions which arise while we are doing this, while we are trying to process our accrual accounting statements in our offices. Now, fundamentals of accrual accounting and why at all we needed is a question. I think we all had a big discussion on this earlier. And we all are now certain that we have to shift to accrual-based accounting systems. The methodology which has been adopted in Railways for following the accrual-based system, accrual accounting system, is the grafting methodology. What is this grafting methodology? You have two types of methods. One is called transaction-based in the transaction-based system, what happens is actually you're right from the origination of the transaction, we adopt the accrual system, which is done in the private companies and in the various other organizations. And that methodology is adopted in systems wherein you won't have any fixed methodology for following maintenance of accounts. But we in Railways have a very, very sound system of accounting which is far more advanced in certain areas and slightly backward in certain areas when compared to the systems which are maintained outside Railways. So, like, without going into too much of details about that, which are the areas of actual impact which we will be having in our while we are trying to shift, and what is transaction based? I try to explain in very brief. Right at the beginning inception, starting of the transaction itself, we will be recording the transaction on accrual base. That is called a transaction base. For instance, if you have a transaction emanating from an executive's office, at the stage of accrual itself, when the material is received itself, the expenditure is recorded in the books of accounts. Today, we are recording the transaction only at the time that the cash payment is being made to the party. That means when the abstract is prepared, all the COs are gone, the abstract banne ke baad, it comes to the books of accounts of the That is the main difference between the transaction based system and the present system. What will happen, how are we going to go ahead, and how are we going to, what is the methodology we are adopting for the purpose of we are adopting what is called the grafting methodology. In grafting methodology, what happens is, wherever we have the accrual impact, we will be detaching those areas of accrual impact, and then straight away we will be adding that information to the accrual statements, which will help in the total appearance. One second, all of you. Actually, it was an urgent time, so I cleared it. Now, the basic methodology which we are adopting is a grafting methodology. wherein we only identify those areas where we are having the accrual impact, and that accrual impact we will be attaching to our existing system of accounting, and that will help in converting the entire system of our system, existing system, to the financial accrual financial statements which we are having. Then, first of all, you must be wondering, what is this man speaking? How are you going to convert? Very simple methodology. We have our final account current in the month of March. Once we have the final account current, that final account current represents the transactions which have taken place during that particular financial year. All of us are aware of it. We have the opening balances of the previous years, and we also have transactions of this particular year. That is, which is the form of account current. We have to identify those items wherein accrual impact is there. We will be identifying those items where accrual impact is there, segregating those items separately, and then adding that accrual impact to our account, applying that accrual impact to our account. With the balances, opening balances we keep on having, we carry it forward. Once we carry forward the opening balances along with our account current, which reflects that year's transactions, and the accrual impact. Now here, one more very, very important KPI is there. We have this fixed assets. Everybody was speaking about the element of depreciation. How are we going to take that into account? That will really have an impact on our books. Definitely. Therefore, the fixed assets also play a very important role. And therefore, we have different sets of financial statements which have come into existence, wherein we have updated these financial statements. Once we have identified that fixed assets are very important and the accrual impact statements are very important. Now these statements, how are we updating these statements, and where are we going to update these? This is what we are going to look at in this particular session. Let me just take you to a particular PPT which was shared by our friend the chartered accountant, Mr. Vikas Mahesh, who was there a few years back, and he was training everybody. I am sharing the same PPT with all of you. So, let me just share the PPT. I hope all of you are seeing this particular screen. Gentlemen, are you seeing the PPT?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is visible.
Thank you. Now this is the PPT which was presented, and this PPT actually gives you a summary of what we have spoken just a few minutes back. Well, we have to see, this is the brief summary which was given, why of your financial statements is being discussed here. Do we at all need to convert to accrual system of accounting was also discussed in this particular slide. And you can see that everybody, see, it's something like this. Accrual accounting is not a need for railways. But then outsiders have to understand that the system of railways, we have to speak in their language. And only when we speak in their language, they will understand. Now, when they are all following totally different standards, we are following different standards, and we are applying different totally different interpretations. That is where the difference comes in. That is why, and we have some regulatory issues also. Possibly today we have not yet opened up. Tomorrow, when you have a rail development authority coming in, you will have something on par with by electricity regulatory authority. You have so many regulatory authorities today which actually act for the purpose of fixation of the rates. And in such a regulatory one white paper on the RDA, Rail Development Environmental Committee, they have mentioned very clearly that the cost fixation should be on accrual accounts, sound accrual accounts only, on accounts which are based on sound accrual accounting principles only. Therefore, this particular area, that is why the why of the accrual accounting system has come into existence. Now, when we look at the financial statements, there are three very important statements which come in. One is the balance sheet, the second one is your P&L account, and third one is your cash flow statement. The statement which is beneath the statement of changes in the net assets and equity is no longer being prepared, it's the cash flow which is there. These three statements, that is your balance sheet, profit and loss account, and the cash flow, are derived from your trial balance. They are derived from your trial balance. See, when you look at the financial statements, the distribution, you can just see here, your generally your balance sheets, anywhere you look at them, outside balance sheet, you will find the assets and liabilities, which will be reflecting the total financial position of a particular organization on a particular day. Whereas your P&L account and your cash flows statements will be reflecting the area of expenditure, where the expenditure has been incurred, and where the investments have taken place in your organization, and also the profitability of the present financial year. This is reflected in your P&L account. Now, all these things combined together will in the balance sheet, which will flow into the balance sheet and also position of the organization. How do we go about preparing the financial statements? The process of the financial statements is something like this. The opening balance is just like how we have already explained. We will take the opening balances of the previous year. Then we will, up to 2016-17, we have already finalized the accrual accounting financial statements, which have been certified by CAs already, and we have submitted them to CPM AR also on board. But 2017-18, the zonal values are responsible for finalizing the statements. So we already have the opening balances which have been carried forward from the year 2016-17 of all the items. The same opening balances will be carried forward, and the final account for end of March 2018 will be the basis which will be the one which will be used for the purpose of actually identifying the transactions of that particular year. And that is the second step here. That is final accountant. It's not here very carefully. The changes which have been made to the supplementary one, March supplementary one, two, and three, you have to take the last one or more, wherever you have the last statement, the final accountant is there. That is the most important statement. Because if you take anything subsequent to that, the changes which you have already made will not be figuring in that original account current, and that will reflect the wrong picture. So please take the last account current which was approved by the audit, and on the basis of which the final appropriation accounts have been finalized. And the next stage is the main grafting where the grafting methodology will apply. That is your depreciation impact from your PPRs and your CACLs which are there. CACLs means current assets and current liabilities. We have identified where the impact of that particular year's transactions will be, which need to be applied upon the final account current, will be reflected here. And some total of this, that is the opening balance plus final account current minus or plus of your accrual impact rates, will give you the final accrual based financial statements on drafting methodology. This is the summary of the entire session. That is, opening balances will be carried forward to the previous year. Transactions of this year's financial accounts will have to be reflected in your final account current, whichever you have submitted last. And your accrual impact statements have to be drawn from your CACLs and the FARs. FARs may depreciation part of it will go to the P&L account, and your fixed assets will be transferred. That is, fixed assets balances will be added to the fixed assets of last year minus the depreciation impact will be carried forward to the balance sheet. And on the basis of it, you are having your accrual based financial statements on drafting methodology ready. Now, what is the methodology which is adopted? We have very detailed methodology which has been given in your implementation modules. And the updation of the fixed asset registers on the basis of the transactions which have taken place in that financial year. This will really help you in actually updation of your fixed assets registers. It has you have forms from FPR 1 to FPR 18, and FPR, the most important forms are FPR 5 and 12, which are being uploaded by only the board. They have not provided this facility to us. And trial balance in this particular process, what we have to do is from the account current we have to prepare the TV. TV will also have the opening balances of the previous year. TV will not have the opening balances, but the account current will have the, from the account current alone we'll be taking the, we'll be preparing the TV, and when we carry forward to our balance sheet, we'll be adding the opening balance of the previous year. And from there, we'll be carrying forward the accrual impact statements. That is how we'll carry forward to the next. We will carry forward the same information to the balance sheets also. Now, the most important part of your FPRs is the life of the assets. The information, there are certain fields which are mandatory. And only when we provide that information, it will be accepted. The date of acquisition of a particular asset has to be given. And apart from the date, the life of the asset has to be given. Why? The entire depreciation is calculated on a straight line methodology. Depending upon the life of the asset, the cost of that particular, the depreciation of that particular asset will be calculated also. Therefore, invariably we have to provide the date of acquisition and the life of the asset in all the statements. The life of the asset varies from asset to asset. For instance, if you go in for a PCs and other assets, we have 4 years. For our track, it's taken us 25 years, must be 25 years, 30 years. For a building, it is 60 years. So it depends. Everything has been captured in the statement separately. So based on the FARs, you need to feed that information from our present bypass records. We have to identify these transactions and feed them into our FAR statements, which are there already in a system called ARMS. I believe IDs have already been distributed to all the accounting units, and each and every accounting unit needs to actually go to the basic registers. I mean, the executive has to give the information to the accounting unit, and the accounting unit needs to update that information. This is very, very important as far as the sorry, you were not able to see the individual slides. Yeah. Is it okay now?
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Actually, individual slides, I have not shown you this individual slides. So let me just take you back once again. Just at the cost of repetition, I believe we all know this. The income and expenditure is recorded in the P&L account, and you have three fundamental financial statements which we have to prepare: balance sheet, P&L account, and cash flow. And for the balance sheet, you have the assets and liabilities which are reflected, and you have also have the current and non-current assets which are reflected, as well as the liabilities which are in the P&L account. The profit or certain transactions will be carried forward from P&L account to your balance sheet also, like depreciation and any other expenditure which is any other adjustments which need to be carried forward to your balance sheet. Now, the methodology to be adopted for the purpose of preparation of financial statements on the basis of accrual system will be that the opening balance plus your final account current plus your accrual impact statements, accrual impact statements will be your FARs and CACLs both together. Because why am I saying this, that CAC FARs are also going to be there, because your depreciation element will be calculated only on the basis of your FARs. And depreciation will be reflected in the P&L account, and then that will also be shown as a reduction in your balance sheet. So that is how it goes. Then the fixed assets registers updation, it is always, all the entire final accounts or your annual accounts will be dependent on what is called your trial balance. Final account current should be, we have your receipts and outgoings in our final account current, and when you both those receipts and outgoings have to be matched, and the TB has to be prepared for the final account current. And from that, we have to apply your accrual impact also. And when we are applying the accrual impact, you get these summaries which you have to carry forward to your balance sheets. You also have to include the opening balance there. I'll show you specifically a few forms. And this data has to be obtained and filled in a system called ARMS. There is a system which is wherein IDs have been provided along that ARMS IDs have been provided, and everybody, the FARs and the CACLs have to be uploaded by the units on the basis of putting the records in the executive offices. See, all the FARs are not applicable to everybody, for instance. You have construction office wherein you have a construction office wherein your FAR 13 only comes. Where you have inventories which are being maintained, like stores department, departments, you have only CA10 and 10A forms coming. Like this, you have different offices which will be having only a particular specific form. So all the rest of the forms will become a nil category, you know, and only that specific forms they need to fill up and send it forward into the headquarters, and headquarters will further get it certified with data content, and they will forward these forms to CPM AR. Now, which are the areas where you may have an accrual impact? One of the most important area where you may have an accrual impact is PRS transactions, especially. In PRS transactions, we receive the amounts in advance. Actually, the BRS earnings are received in advance, and we have to segregate those transactions when service was rendered by us, and that only that portion we need to include in that financial year's statements. This segregation is done wherever the earnings have been received in advance. We also have transactions where earnings have to be received, but they have not been realized. So such earnings also have to be brought in account. There are certain areas wherein the services or supplies have been made, but the payment has not been made. That area also we will provide. But for instance, most of our contractors' bills, the contractors' bills are there in the month of February. What happens is we actually don't make the payments because the funds are not available. Actually, the work has been completed, right? It has been certified by the executive. But once it has been certified by the executive and the funds are not available, the asset is not recorded in the books of accounts at all. Because of that, what happens is the supply has already been made. The asset is being brought to use, but it has not been brought to the books of accounts because we make the payment subsequent to the next year. That sort of delayed payments also brought to book, and this data will be captured in our full impact sheets. Now, we have tried to get a difference between the trial balance and account current, and in this you will find that the account current does not have the opening balances, whereas the trial balance will have the opening balances, and it will carry forward the amounts that are there in the previous year also. The appropriation accounts are on the basis of our account current only. This obviously, this is on for the purpose of government accounting. There are fees for the purpose of preparing financial statements on a global basis. Now, if you look at it further, the trial balance preparation will have certain nuances which are very interesting. What will happen to deposits which we are having? What will happen to the deposits which we are having? How are we going to go home with our deposits? Can we treat them as loans? Or we should treat them as liabilities as well as current loans which we can move later? All these have to be analyzed item wise by the chartered accountant, and those items wherein the real macro impact that we have to segregate and mark them. I'll just show you one Excel sheet which we have prepared. We have asked our chartered accountant on the basis of that contract after some time. Once we go through the entire slides, you have your capital expenditure also being taken from our account current, and all these details are very, very important for the purpose of assessing preparing our financial statements. See, a certain basis of evaluation. Reasons, we may have number of differences between our total amount which has been spent, our demand number 16 hour, and our fixed assets register. We will have a difference. Reason for that is basically the block account. In the block account, we are full cost basis. Whereas the fixed assets standard cost they are arriving at, and it shows the expenditure of the current year only, demand number 16, whereas also shows assets of the which are lying at the opening balance of block account. Block account will show items which will be really clear. They are in. Because of that, that difference will be carried forward. In some areas, the value of the asset cyclically has been taken as one.
Hello?
Land, especially, we don't, that's only one, no, but where we don't have the actual cost of something incurred. That we have shown, that's only one. So, the actual cost incurred might have been spent by us and it would be reflected in the value. Now, assets procured from revenue, they actually are reflected in the capital expenditure also. But then, they are spent from the revenue, therefore they will not be reflected in the capital demand. But the demand number 16 may be only declining. Yeah, revenue may discourage us. Office equipment, most of our office equipment, we are using revenue. When we are getting it, when we are purchasing such items, we are not in a position wherein we can. We are not in a position wherein we can trace the transaction from our revenue. Now, all these things are available with all of you. DWFA is one area wherein demand number 16, we only treat that expenditure which we have paid for in demand number 16. Whereas in TWFA, we reflect the actual transactions which have taken place between the zonal values. So this also will be one of the reasons which can be there. Another area is your impact of improvement element which is there in your DRF. All these aspects have been covered here. You can all go through these slides at your leisure. Because this particular subject is so exhaustive that it is very difficult to cover the entire subject within 1.5 hours. I'm just trying to give you a brief of how we go about preparing our payouts. Basically, that is the fundamental objective. And how do we reconcile the expenditure between the difference between the payouts and our actual demand number 16? Can we check it out and can we actually assess whether the figures in the FARs are reflecting the correct details or not? We need to make a small assessment and identify in the light of the capital expenditure. We just need to identify, otherwise we will not be able to compare the figures and to identify whether the figures are correctly reflected in the FARs or not is something which we have to assess very carefully. Now this is as far as the first slide is concerned, and I would like to take another slide also, another PPT also. The number of PPTs which are there, which I have already shared with all of you, so you can go through those PPTs. I hope the new PPT is visible to all of you. Any one of you can respond, please. Thank you. I think it is visible. I'm assuming that it is visible here. Now, how do we actually go ahead? And finalize our FARs. Who is the actual custodian of the fundamental registers, and on what basis are we going to fill up our FARs in our offices? Oh, iske liye to bahut sare registers hain. these registers are available in our engineering department, and they have to actually give this data to us for the purpose of filling up our the AIR forms. So we have to follow up with the executives. Each and every one of our officers, we have to follow up with the executives. Now, you can see the FAR numbers. Land acquired will be a cost, but it will not have depreciation. Therefore, you will find that the FAR 1 will not have depreciation. But in all the rest of the FARs, you will be having the depreciation in these FARs, the FAR 5, rails, sleepers, ballast and other equipment, TMS systems extractor. This is being done at CPM AR level, and they are actually uploading these FARs. We don't have to do this. This is a very major work they are thinking about. But the rest of the FARs, that is 1 to 4 and 6 to 11, 1 to 4 and 6 to 11, we have to do it. Again, 12A, B and C is being done at the CPM AR level. That means FARs 5 and FARs 12 are being done at the CPM AR level. Now, you have all the rest of the FARs, wherein you have your desktop register as a fundamental property. Most of the documents are there in your desktop registers. And it should not be very difficult for the departments to give the data. Once they give the data, we have to enter the number FARs. For simplicity, what we have done in South Central Railway is, on the basis of the PUs, we try to assess where this particular asset, if there is an acquisition of an asset, where will this fit in? So we try to make a classification of it, and we send it to each and every accounting unit to help them in identifying the transactions and getting the data from the executive offices. This exercise we have done for the year 2017-18. We may have to do this exercise at the unit level so that this FARs exercise is completed at the earliest. FAR for 2018 and 2019 financial year also needs to be completed. This also would be done at the earliest. Now you can see the summary of this. Most of the data can be had from single registers that are maintained at various executive offices. So coordination with our executive offices for the purpose of preparation of FARs is a must. Here we should remember again, only FAR 1 will not have depreciation. All the rest of the FARs, we have the information available in IPAS also, the internal check module. We can easily capture the data from our IPAS, the IC module, and from that data we can extract the information which is required for 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. What are these FARs relating to? 6 relates to furniture and fittings, office equipment, vehicles, plant and machinery, 10 relates to computers and peripherals, 11 to medical equipment. Medical is very simple from our medical department expenditure head. We can easily identify this particular expenditure. And intangible assets, if they are created, again, you should have it in the desktop register. But I'm not sure whether we have any intangible assets, because we do not have any patents or other type of assets. In case anything is there, we are involved in structure this time. Now, what are the types of transactions which are not recorded in the systems which we have. Works completed but liability not discharged fully. This data is not available. That's what I was referring to. Bills have been have not been paid, but work has been completed. This is not there. And income which pertains to the next years, this has to be extracted from DRS system. Waily charges. See, we collect waily charges for nearly 10 years. When we collect the waily charges in advance, that is actually an income for which is accruing, which is a future income which has been received in advance. So we need to segregate this income into the years in which that particular bailiff applies. So that segregation is not there in our systems. Then all the rest, I think accrual impact, all these areas we need to cover. We can, as we have already discussed in the internal check module, we can capture this particular data from our IPAS also. And demand number 16 data we will be getting from IRPSM as well as from our IPAS. We can extract. And this, see, once work has been completed, whether we should put it into CWIP or whether as the completion report, only when the completion report is given, the asset is transferred to open line. Should we keep our assets in CWIP till that day? These are questions which we have not asked ourselves. There are a number of areas where doubts are there as to what are the various, whether we should treat it as CWIP, because when you treat it as CWIP, the element of asset, portion of it only comes under the block of assets. The methodology for treating of depreciation is different for CWIP and such sort of differences will be there. Like in the treatment of the various assets. I think we have already discussed this value charges and expenditure incurred already to supply ho gaya hai, uska paisa nahi bhari. I mean, we have not paid the money still to the parties for such type of transactions also. We need to record this at the time when the supply has been made and the supply has been accepted by railways. That date should become the basis for, if you take that as the basis, then it is transaction based analysis which we are not doing. But this information, when it was supplied, if it is there, then we can transform those records into approval impact state. We can include them in our actual impact statements so that we can get these details from our IMMIS or IPAS itself. Now I'm going to share with all of you one more statement. I've shared the implementation modules, the ARMS screen. I'll show you the ARMS screen also, how it looks like, so that we have some help. Are you all seeing this PDF which I have opened right now? Can any one of you just tell me? Okay, I'm sharing a PDF with all of you. Yeah, Sitara, can you just tell me whether you're seeing this PDF?
Little more zoom, if you zoom it, it will be more visible.
Okay, done. I'm doing it. reasons for building up of the practical impact fields I've already shared with you. I think these must be available with all of you. You are working in the actual accounting area. So when you are working in those areas, please go through these actual impact statements, which are real guidelines for you to feed in the data. Because so many nuances will come to light when you are actually doing the work. Say for instance, we'll take one information. Yeah. We'll go to CA2 first. And advance, we'll just analyze one CA, and it becomes easier for all of you to understand. Any advance, yeah? Somebody was writing any question, please. Okay. An advance refers to any sum paid which is recoverable in cash or kind. For example, any amount of advance paid to a supplier for material also is an advance. What are the types of advances we are providing in this? These advances, what have been mentioned here, are only advances which are given to employees.
Mr. K, akhon ekta mobile ta chai.
Hello? I'm getting a cross talk. So, these advances are related to employee advances, which we will be reflecting in our CA 2. Now, in these advances, suppose in stores we have paid certain amounts, those have to be reflected separately. Especially for advances for purchases made. Then, MAR ka data you have to include here in the miscellaneous advances, that is CA3. EMDs which we receive from various parties, we have to record in CA4. Now this transfer debit and transfer credit transactions that is which are available in CA5. Gentlemen, this is an information which is available in our account current also. So you can transfer that data from there, unit wise. This will be nil for the entire Indian Railways community, that's the hope. Because it does not have an impact on the Railways. So that we have to keep in mind when we are talking about these transfer debits and transfer credits. Here, every one of us knows this is one key area wherein this have to be raised by us for the future. If we are receiving any amount which relates to the future, we may have to bring it here into CAs. If we are new in the amounts of the future, that becomes current asset. If we are, a rent for a particular ATM has not been paid by us. If rent has not been paid by SBI, then this particular rent, ATM rent which we have to get, will be reflected in current assets as pending dues. Suppose we have received any money in advance for a particular contract, it will be reflected in your CLs. This we have to take it very carefully and carry it forward. See, bank balances, all this will come from our account current. We can take this information right from our account current itself. And RIB and checksum bills also will be carried forward here. Cash and cash equivalents, departmental balances, basically interest balances which are there, definitely we have to put them into this particular area of cash and cash equivalents. Departmental balances are not being included here. Generally, our departmental which are there and the floating balances which are available to the institution. And inventory, 10, CA10 is one of the most important forms wherein we have to, any inventory which has been supplied, basically, this can be tracked when we are looking at our PU 27 and 28 from IPAS. We can track this information. Right? This is a very very easy method because we have the stock and non-stock items. They are very rightly written here. From this, we can track our information and get the details for our forms. Each and every accounting unit, we can get these details and significant inventories which are there, we have to bring them to the ABC analysis is a method that they have suggested here. That methodology could be for the purpose of including items in CA10. Then you have diesel which comes in CA10A. Further, you have details of interest also. Now, fine. These are various forms. I think you can go through these presentations. These are PDFs which I have already shared with you. All this information is already available
in the
forms.
Hello?
Anybody has any doubts, please come back. Or mute your phone.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will give another 15 minutes to for all of you to ask me questions on this subject. I will also be sharing with you one screen, actually ARMS screen. I just thought I need to share with you so that you will have an idea of how the ARMS screen looks like and what are the processes which are here. So, I am just showing you this ARMS screen. Gentlemen, this is pertaining, this is the ARMS screen of Southern Mobile Bay. Every unit can actually view this particular screen. In the screen, if you look at it, you will find the fixed assets registers, current assets registers, and current liabilities for the year 2017. Which have been filed by every accountant. All you need to do is tap, you will get the status of your screens. Now, uploading of FARs, how do you do it? What is the status of your files which have been uploaded? Even that can be verified. See, each and every file can be verified at which stage it is available. Who has uploaded this information, where is it, whether it has been forwarded to CAs, and CAs have forwarded them to the CPMAR, those status can be verified here. Now, apart from this, you are at the facility of downloading the information, whatever has been uploaded by the various entities. You go to I'll just download one particular statement for all of you and look at. This is construction office Secunderabad, wherein they have filed only FAR 13. So we can just go and look into those FAR forms. FAR 10 which they have filed. See, FAR 10 includes all computer peripherals. You can, I'm just showing you a file. I think I'll have to share that Excel sheet. This is FAR 10 form which has been filled in by construction office. Now, once this form is there, you can just see all the forms. The date of acquisition is given here. Reference number is your desktop page number, and then you have the total number of units, cost per unit, all that will be there, and number of years of assets, life is here, life as per the total provisions is, what's the life as per the golden coins? Are they given here? And accumulated depreciation, what is it? And book value as on date. These are all automatically calculated. Therefore, it helps in our are you all seeing this ARMS?
Yes, sir.
ARMS dikh raha na?
Yes,
I see details of computer sir.
Dikh raha hai sir, dikh raha hai.
ये ARMS जिस ऐसे फॉर्म्स फिलअप करके आपको अपलोड करना है, ऐसे बहुत सारे फॉर्म्स होते हैं. इवन इफ यू लुक एट द सी इट इज सो वेरी सिंपल टू फिल इन दिस फॉर्म्स. इफ वी आर गेटिंग द इंडियन स्टॉक रजिस्टर्स एंड आवर ओरिजिनल रजिस्टर्स व्हिच वी हैव एक्चुअली डिस्कस्ड इन वन ऑफ द प्रेजेंटेशंस, द एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफिस अगर वो लोग एक्टिव तौर से कोऑपरेट करेंगे सभी जगह पे, वी आर ऑलवेज द प्रॉब्लम नॉट गेटिंग द डाटा फ्रॉम द एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफिस. इफ वी कैन असिस्ट लाइक हाउ वी हैव डन इट ऑन द व्हाट वी हैव डन इज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द पीयूस, वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड व्हिच पीयू विल बी हैविंग दिस फंक्शंस फॉर कंप्यूटर विल बी हैविंग 51. आई थिंक 51 इज अ पीयू, 51 इज अ पीयू. सो 51 52 का पेरिफेरल्स वी आर हैविंग कंप्यूटर पेरिफेरल्स. 51 52 में जो भी एक्सपेंडिचर हुआ we'll take it into account and then we'll say that so many computers have been procured. And like this, we 99% we try to segregate it and send it to the accounting unit so that they can, we can share the data, the accounting unit in turn can share the data with the units so that they can work on the they can work on the FARs and quick uploading there. Then, kindly mute your. Thank you. When we are working on the FARs and CACLs, the CACLs actually represent the actual impact on media practice. CACLs may actual impact ek baar record. Yeah. So, we can straight away extract the information and then अगर एक जगह पे एक अकाउंट डाल दिए तो ऑटोमेटिकली आपका पी एन एल और बैलेंस शीट निकल के आ जाएगा और देर नहीं लगेगा ये फाइनल अकाउंट बनाने में. Lekin, what is identifying and putting the data in the FARs and CACLs, that is success. Once we identify the item that is pertaining to the FAR, we have to that is the most important part of your entire exercise. Every accounting needs to work on this particular area and sharing the information with the executive and ensuring that what is recorded in their debt stock registers or their original registers is reflected in our FARs. Ye ensure kar diye to our work will go faster. This is where we are facing a problem in people. I mean, I will take questions from all of you. Please ask questions because it has been a one-way session. Sir, I received a question. Somebody has asked me here whether at marks, can I read? I'm reading a few questions which I've already received. Whether any advance payments made to suppliers and contractors are treated as sundry debtors? Yes, definitely. Advance payments made, we have already discussed earlier, mobilization advance definitely will come under sundry debtors. Similarly, materials received but payments not made should be treated as sundry creditors. Agree? There's no doubt about it. Then I have, I don't know, I have to remote delivery बोल के आया. Then sir, at present I'm working at DC section of Central Railway books. How the actual accounting will impact my working on DC address? Very good. Nice question. Actually, your forms C5 and 6 will reflect the entire TC adjustments and TR adjustments with other railways. See, there
are I question you. Go on explaining.
Madam? Bolliye madam.
Go on explaining. I am Rama Sengupta from Central Railway Books. I will ask the question.
Yeah, madam. Go ahead, madam.
You explain it. I am listening.
Yeah, definitely CA 5 and 6 we have to fill in, madam.
Okay.
We have to fill in CA 5 and 6.
Okay.
You are in Central Books, madam. Central Books,
yes.
Or accounting unit?
Sir, Central Railway Books Headquarters.
Headquarters mein hai. Headquarters mein hai, to apne Central Railway Headquarters unit ka jo PCs hai, aap log ko upload karna padega. Accounting units का जो CAs है ना, CA 5 और 6, they will upload for their units. Each and every accounting unit is responsible for their uploading. Right, madam?
Okay. Yes.
Clear, yeah, madam?
Yes. And sir, if suppose now I am dealing with zonal railway, then what will be the impact of actual accounting when it will come into force?
What will be the impact of it?
Yes. How it will, I will operate. Now I am doing zonal railways adjustment, CC adjustment.
Okay.
In Central Railway Books. Then when the actual accounting will come into force, how I will work?
Madam, at present we are following both systems, na? Hum log dono system follow kar rahe hain. See, what methodology we have adopted here is the grafting methodology. Here we have adopted the grafting methodology. So, in case in future we are shifting to transaction-based accrual accounting. If we shift to transaction-based accrual accounting system, that means we will be totally adopting all the accounting standards which have been prescribed by ICAI and MCA and all that. If we are doing that, then there will be a huge change. But at present, okay. We are adopting grafting methodology, which is based, for which the basic record is our final account current only. Right? The fundamental base is our account current only. So, basic document jo hai, account current hai. Uske aadhar pe, jahan pe actual impact hua hai, usko hum log segregate kar leke, add kar leke. Bas. It should not have a major impact. But then, for the purpose of costing, we have to actually shift to accrual-based system to assess whether our statements, the cost of service rendered, jo hota hai na, service rendered, uska cost ko assess karne ke liye on accrual systems, this method is. They're shifting to this particular methodology. Right?
Okay. Thank you, sir.
See, I would love questions from all the participants, please. Because while you're asking questions, so many other aspects we can discuss.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, what is debt stock you have mentioned? Debt asset?
Debt stock register is a register wherein all the assets procured by any of the accounting units. Which department or which office are you from?
Sir, I'm accounts office. Sorry.
Accounts office. Executive offices mein jo bhi yahan pe bhi jayenge aap, wahan pe ek register maintain kiya jata hai wherein to store all the assets which are there. Including chairs, stationery, everything. Uska ek register mein entry hota hai. That's called the debt stock register. Mane apne operations ke liye directly jo hum log use nahi karte. those assets which we are procuring for money, but we don't compute the compulsory item.
टर्मिनोलॉजी
डिफर फ्रॉम रेलवे टू रेलवे. See, what happens is TNP register will be station may get the TNP register. We go to an institution where in training is going to call it a desktop register. So it just depends. See, where are we recording the assets? That's the most important. Right?
Thank you.
I hope I'm clear.
Yes, thank you.
It is the recording of the asset which is most important. It is the date of acquisition. See, yahan pe ek sample form of the file. The date of acquisition is important. The life of the asset is very important. Date of acquisition and the life of the asset is most important. Before we are accepting it. We are feeding it into the system.
We can say that data stock register is a asset register.
It's almost here. You can wherever you have the details of the assets recorded, whichever register it is, you will have one register in every office. Hamara har ek office mein ek register hoga jahan pe original assets ko hum log record karte hain.
So data stock register is asset register hua sir?
Yeah, obviously. See, for instance, each office you will be having. See, rolling stock register, bulk ek register hai. Kahan pe hoga wo?
Workshop pe hoga.
Depending on the office in which it is utilized, there you will have a particular register which records the details of the assets, right?
Okay.
Works register hai. Jahan pe work ho raha, works register hai. Hai na? ऐसे जहाँ पे एसेट्स का रिकॉर्डिंग होता है उसी फंडामेंटल डॉक्यूमेंट से लॉजिक इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग हियर. यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड दैट द फंडामेंटल डॉक्यूमेंट है जहाँ पे बेस सबसे पहले हम लोग डेस्कटॉप रजिस्टर का पेजेस होते हैं. आई थिंक यू हैव सीन द डेस्कटॉप रजिस्टर जहाँ पे सीरियली इट इज सीरियली नंबर एंड देयर इन ऑल द एसेट्स आर रिकॉर्डेड इन अ पर्टिकुलर सीक्वेंशियल ऑर्डर. And only after entering the desktop register, bill is passed in that office. You know, हम लोग use the desktop register का details पता होगी क्योंकि वो register में वो दिखना चाहिए. ठीक है? I hope I have answered your question. Any other question?
Yes, sir. Very clear. Very clear.
Thank
you. And sir,
yeah.
मोबिलाइजेशन एडवांस क्या होता है सर? मोबिलाइजेशन एडवांस प्लीज हिंदी में एक्सप्लेन करें सर.
कुछ नहीं, काम करने के लिए हमारे पास पैसा नहीं है यार. एक वर्क्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट आपको अलॉट हो गया है?
जी जी.
पैसा नहीं है हमारे पास तो हम लोग क्या करें? वी हैव एक्चुअली वी हैव सेड वी विल बी मनी इन एडवांस टू कंप्लीट द वर्क. थोड़ा पैसा हम लोग दे देते हैं उनको काम करते हैं, लेकिन मोबिलाइजेशन एडवांस इज नो लॉन्गर देयर एंड प्रैक्टिस नो लॉन्गर देयर राइट.
अच्छा, तो इसमें कोई परसेंटेज की बाध्यता नहीं सर कि कितना परसेंटेज लिया जाएगा? Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
We are not encouraging people to give the mobilization. So we are not.
Okay, sir.
Sir, work register का जो है book section से क्या संबंध है sir?
क्या जी?
Work register जो होता है sir, उसका book section में कैसे maintain होता है?
Book section में क्यों maintain होगा वो?
Work register यानी expenditure में maintain होगा.
Work register is not maintained in a book section. Construction office के office में होगा. Yeah, it will be there in the executive office. Copy of it is maintained in
the office.
ठीक है बुक सेक्शन में क्यों मेंटेन करते हो
ओके सर
राइट नेक्स्ट प्लीज नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नाउ आई वांट Then the entire debits and credits under purchases by the place agreed. I think this gentleman is again from this I think Lenovo. Yeah, definitely, madam. Purchase suspense register may jo bhi entry. I'm just reading the chat actually. Purchase suspense by debits and credits could find a place in your CSES.
Okay,
so Yeah? I'm not getting the voice clearly, please. Anybody else has any question? I think I have a chat.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, what the importance of equal accounting in
Yeah?
What the major importance in railway for equal accounting?
Actually, thanks for the question. Actually, I hope that somebody will be asking me this question. It is, what happens is actually now you have read so many reports, right? Wherein trains are going to be privatized. ऐसे भी पता है ना प्राइवेट पार्टीज आर आल्सो गोइंग टू कम एंड स्टार्ट रनिंग ट्रेन्स फॉर रेलवेज व्हेन यू आर हैविंग प्राइवेट पार्टीज रनिंग ट्रेन्स फॉर रेलवेज यू हैव टू फिक्स अ पर्टिकुलर रेट फॉर द सर्विस रेंटर्ड राइट इफ यू डू नॉट हैव ऑल द कॉस्ट व्हिच हैव बीन इनकर्ड प्रॉपरली in place, then the price at which we are selling our service will go wrong. There is going to be one organization which is going to come in place, which is called Rail Development Authority. Once Rail Development Authority comes, the fundamental basis for fixing of the price for the service rendered will be on the basis of only equal accounting based accounts. Right? Say for instance, let us say you have replaced a major part of a particular electrical loop. Very bada major part of your from IC if I can see that. You have replaced a very important part of an electrical loop. Once you have replaced an electrical part, the cost of that particular electrical logo, the logo has been repaired and you are using that particular electrical logo. When you are using that electrical logo, you have not paid the bill, but you have already started using that electrical logo. Have you included all the costs in your books? No. Because we have not paid the bill. It's a pending amount, right?
Yes.
So when we shift to accrual accounting, what will happen is that cost will be added to your cost and you will arrive at the current cost of service rendered. It's the basic point for which all of us will be working out. We are preparing our financial reports on accrual. That's the main reason.
What about the annual maintenance contract? The value of AMCs.
AMCs.
Yeah,
AMCs are we, in certain cases, AMCs we are paying on monthly basis, right? In certain cases. If it is on a monthly basis, it is accounted only on a monthly basis. Suppose it is pending. Payment is pending. for some service which has already been rendered, definitely that has to be included in our CLs.
CLs?
Current liabilities, madam. करंट लाइबिलिटीज में हम लोग इंक्लूड करना है क्योंकि सर्विस रेंडर हो गया मैडम. हर एक सर्विस का जस्ट लेट अस से वो भी एचएस कॉन्ट्रैक्ट है, सर्विस रेंडर हो गया उनका का, बिकॉज़ दीस आर ऑल रनिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स वेयर इन दीस आर ऑल पेड ऑन अ मंथली बेसिस. सो व्हेन वी आर डूइंग दैट व्हाट विल हैपन इज द मंथ का जो हम लोग बिल क्लियर नहीं करें तो उसको लेके जाके दो तीन महीने में तो हम लोग बिल क्लियर करना है. See here, that any definition of a current asset or a current liability is slightly blurred. Sabhi jagah pe fixed asset or current asset ka jo definition hai blurred hai. Lekin please remember, the asset, the expenditure which is incurred, which has to be incurred or which has to be cleared within 1 year. Has to be treated as a current asset or a current liability. Wherever the asset is going to be utilized beyond 1 year, you have to treat it as a fixed asset. Then you would push it to APS. That is the implementation guidelines. If you have read it, you will have clarity. I have already shared the implementation guidelines also. So that you can just go through once that FAS, implementation of rule accounting in India, by this will take study here. I just shared that with all of
you. It's in practice, right, sir?
Yeah, it's in practice.
West Central, then? Or West Central?
Yeah, it is in practice. We have already, I've shown you the ARM screens also, right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
I've shared with you the ARMS screen.
Yeah, I'll take again.
I've shared with you even the ARMS manual so that you can go through those manuals and understand the systems that exist.
Right.
Thank
you.
Right. Any other questions, please?
Yes.
I'm waiting for questions. Anybody else? No questions. And I would like to. Yeah, go ahead. Somebody was asking.
Sir, accrual accounting का sir एक silent feature क्या summary जो होता है? Accrual accounting का summary sir, summary.
जी
जी. Accrual accounting का main summary क्या सब होता है?
You are appearing for some examination?
जी sir, के लिए candidate sir.
हाँ?
ECR railway sir, समस्तीपुर.
Okay. Accrual accounting का summary बोले तो आप first slide है ना हमारा? उसका समरी का है कुछ नहीं है यहाँ पे तो
सर एक्चुअली ही वांट्स फीचर ऑफ द एक्रुअल अकाउंटिंग
फीचर
सारे आमदनी होता है आमदनी होने के बाद कुछ बचा रहता है तो उसको भी शामिल करते हैं एक्रुअल अकाउंटिंग में
किस शामिल करते हैं जैसे हम लोग पीआरएस में हमारा जो पीआरएस ट्रांजैक्शंस में क्या हो रहा है पैसे हम लोग पहले ही वसूल कर लेते हैं है ना 4 महीने पहले रिजर्वेशन करते हैं हम लोग तो वो आदमी कब ट्रैवल कर रहा बाद में ट्रैवल कर रहा ना तो वो पैसे को तो उसी जिस महीने में सर्विस हुआ उसी महीने में हम लोग खाते में ले जाते हैं
जी सर जी
अपने खाते में कब लेना चाहिए जैसे फरवरी महीने में हम लोग एक टिकट खरीदे लेकिन ट्रैवल कब करने वाले हैं हम लोग मई में करने वाले हैं फरवरी में अपने बुक बुक्स में ला ली है ऑलरेडी, पैसे हम लोग अपने बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स में ला ली है।
जी जी।
जब आप फरवरी का जो पैसा जो आया था हमारे खाते पे ले लिए, और हम लोग सर्विस कब रेंडर करने वाले हैं उसका, मई महीने में जब सर्विस रेंडर करने वाले हैं, यू व्हेन वी आर रेंडरिंग अ सर्विस इन द मंथ ऑफ मे, बट यू हैव अकाउंटेड फॉर द ट्रांजैक्शन इन द मंथ ऑफ फरवरी इटसेल्फ, व्हाट विल हैपन, अपने बुक्स में जो अकाउंट है गलत हो जाएगा ना। सोच लीजिए कि 1000 रुपया का पैसा ज्यादा आ गया, माने हमारे फरवरी के जो अकाउंट है 1000 रुपया ज्यादा दिखाएगा, है ना
जी जी।
लेकिन कब सर्विस रेंडर करने वाले हैं हम लोग, मई में ये 1000 रुपया का जो सर्विस है हम लोग वो महीने में रेंडर करते हैं, वो गलत अकाउंट दिखाएगा ना। ऐसे ही बड़े बड़े खर्चे होते हैं यहाँ पे, बहुत ज्यादा एक्सपेंडिचर, और वो एक्सपेंडिचर हम लोग एक्चुअली वो माल भी आ गया है तो ले लिए और उसको यूज भी कर रहे हैं हमारे डेली सर्विस में, लेकिन हम लोग वो जो बिल है उसका हम रोक के रखे हैं। अगर रोक के रखे तो क्या हो जाएगा, वहां पे बिल तो पैसा भरे नहीं है हम लोग, लेकिन मटेरियल तो यूज कर रहे हैं, ये भी गलत है ना। इसी को बोलते हैं अक्रूवल अकाउंटिंग, इसी को बोलते हैं अक्रूवल अकाउंटिंग प्रॉपर्टी फंडामेंटल। जिस सर्विस जब रेंडर होगा, सर्विस माने ये सप्लाई कुछ भी हो सकता है, सामान का सप्लाई हो सकता है या अपने इसका सप्लाई हो सकता है, क्या बोलते हैं उसको, सर्विस का सप्लाई हो सकता है, जैसे एएमसी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट होगा वो पूरा, ठीक है ना, एक बूट का होगा या सर्विस सर्विस हो सकता है, या दोनों को मिला के वर्क्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट के जैसे दोनों को मिला के भी। सो ये तीनों में जब रेंडर हो गया है, जब खत्म हो गया है, उसी टाइम पे हम लोग अपने बुक्स पे लाना चाहिए। लेकिन कब ला रहे हैं हम लोग, जब सर्विस का पेमेंट होगा, एब्स्ट्रैक्ट जब बनेगा तभी हम लोग बुक्स में ला रहे हैं। दैट इज द रीजन फॉर द डिस्टॉर्शन। डिस्टॉर्शन माने यहाँ पे फर्क आ जाएगा, वो अकाउंट्स में थोड़ा एडजस्ट करना चाहिए आपको, इसीलिए हम लोग सीए सीएल्स करंट एसेट्स और करंट लायबिलिटीज और फिक्स्ड एसेट रजिस्टर्स बना के अपने अक्रूवल इंपैक्ट को हम लोग आइडेंटिफाई करके अकाउंट में लाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं। ठीक है बिरबल जी।
जी सर, थैंक यू सर।
How to treat when sir workman compensation money or SBF money जो हम
SBF
liability, yes SBF money or workman compensation will be huge, you know, during that.
Can I repeat the question once again? SBF or
the money, we give advances from SBF or we give workman compensation.
Okay.
So how these will be treated? Will be treated in the liability side.
SBF, is it a railway fund actually?
Yeah, staff benefit fund.
Staff benefit fund.
For education institution. For
education side. Education. इसके लिए ना reimbursement of tuition.
Not only reimbursement. Yeah, sort of. This is not the reimbursement which we get from through the salary. SBF fund. For the technical education for MBA, those studying in MBA and all. So just simply,
I think I'll have to look into the statements and then get back to you, because this is a specific question. Can you do one thing?
Yeah.
Can you give me your email address in the chat box so that I can just make a note of it, and I'll get back to you on phone or I have. Can you just give me the email address there?
Yes.
I'm just making a note.
Writing it on chat box.
Yeah, please type it. Yes, sir. Treatment stock. Your question is on UPF treatment in CACLs. Right? Your question is SBF treatment and CACL. Let me just look into the statements and then I'll come back to you. Because how we have treated it and how we have analyzed it from when we have shared the same information with our current accountant, I would like to go through those points and then get back to you. Right, Lakshmi Garu? Yeah. The workman compensation also. Fine. I will give you my telephone number also.
Yes, sir, I'm looking now.
And I will leave my email address also so that you can come back to me in case you have any doubts.
Sure, sir.
All the participants can make a note. My personal email ID. And my official number here. You can all come down, you can call me anytime and I'll be glad to take questions from all of you.
Thank you, sir. So that, we can't see your email ID or number. Have you written on the chat box?
Yeah, I put it on the chat box.
I'm not able to see.
That's it. Yes. Okay. I've already posted it. To Sitara, okay. I'll send
it to everybody.
I hope you are able to see it.
Yes,
now.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
That's my email address. And you can all definitely will take on the questions which you are asking. I think I have no more questions from the participants. Let me just turn over myself to Mr. Subramaniam Garu. Namaskaram, sir.
Sir. Good afternoon, sir. That was a very informative session on validation of rural account. Sir, I thank you for taking on this session. I also thank all the participants who have been benefited by this.
Can I share one word, Mr. Subramaniam? I would like to thank Sitara for having invited me for this particular lecture, because it has been a home to me for the purpose of enriching my knowledge by sharing what I have with all of you, and thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Welcome once again for another interesting topic. Tomorrow's session will be on finance expenditure. The speaker for tomorrow's session will be